Hello YouTube. So if you watched the trailer before, I'm trying to make the audio and video better on this channel. So I would really appreciate if you like the video. Drop down a comment below and let me know how you feel about it. And subscribe, because that's what that keeps me going. Lately, I've been getting requests for earphones for gym, earphones for sports activities. And yeah, traveling in India is also a sports activity. So I got my hands onto something and I'm very excited to review it. And if you think this introduction is getting kind of boring, let's just jump into the review. So the product we are reviewing is the Sony MDR-210AP, and the review is gonna be about pros and cons. First up is the build quality, and let me tell you, it looks and feels very premium. The earphones are basically in the shape of your ears, and what might initially seem very tricky to put on, trust me, it's just a matter of seconds once you get used to it, and which should not be more than a week or so. It is built of tangle-free material, which is resistant to some limit, but if you try really hard, you can still mess them. These are specially built for sports activities, so they can handle some amount of beating. I tried them on while doing push-ups, jogging, and other sports activities which I can't put on camera. But the point is, they turned out to be really comfortable. You can wear them for long hours. And yes, talking about sports, these are also splash proof. So they can handle your sweat and you occasionally getting wet. Just don't dip them in water since they are not waterproof. Secondly, I want to point out is the L-shaped headphone jack. This is the most critical point from where your earphones can break. And having a L-shaped jack actually prevents that. By the way, the jack is also gold-plated, which makes it more durable. Sound quality. Well, obviously, this should be the biggest parameter to judge any kind of earphones. What actually attracted me to buy these earphones is the comparatively larger driver size. So basically, all your earphones have a speaker in them. This is what is called driver. So the bigger the driver or the speaker is, the more loud it can get and the deeper bass it will have. So your normal earphones have a driver size of 8 to 9mm, whereas this one has a driver size of 13.5mm. And trust me, she really gets loud. It has very good sound clarity and the audio is crisp. The bass is good, whereas there is that slight hint of noise when you hear at 100% volume. Overall, I would give it an 8 out of 10 for sound. The most underrated thing in an earphone is the mic. Okay, hold on a sec, hear this one out. The sound you're hearing is from the mic of the earphone. And this is amidst huge traffic. And probably this is how you'll sound over the phone. Well, this is a multifunctional microphone. So you tap twice to go to the next song. You tap thrice to go to the previous song. And you long press to access Google Assistant. So I'll be really nitpicking here. There is not much to complain about since it is not an in-ear bud. The noise isolation is pretty bad. You can hear ample amount of surrounding sound, and sometimes it hinders with the music you're listening to. Okay, I said the bass is good, but if you're an avid bass lover, you will be slightly disappointed. Don't get me wrong, majority of the people would still like it. The only problem with these earphones is the pricing. It is priced slightly higher. So you can get Audio-Technica Sennheiser CX-180 at around about 1000 rupees. The main selling point of these earphones is its shape, comfort, and the sound quality. So if you need an earphones for hardcore sports activities and you're ready to pay that extra bit more, this is the best pair you can get at 1300 rupees. And so, with that being said, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.